Hi, everyone. My name is Amy Theory, and I'm the Director of Supports for Formative Assessment here at Smarter Balanced. And so coming today, we really wanted to provide you with a demo of the site, the new site. Let's take a look at the homepage. Right away, you can see that I am from South Dakota. I have an area for search and then some more information. And I also have this navigation bar over here to the left. In a lot of applications, the application bar is at the top of the site, but to maximize the space for users and to have quick access to content, we have it on the left. And you can see we have icons for quick navigation, and then there is a hover over feature that will expand. So it will give you the full content of each of the icons. So you have your homepage icon, your magnifying glass for search to find resources. The clover is for formative assessment strategies, and accessibility strategies is represented by a silhouette, or as I like to think of it, a student. Both the formative assessment strategies and accessibility strategies links will take you to a pre-populated search. So you will have access to all of the formative strategies or all of the accessibility strategies, depending on which one you've selected. At the bottom of the navigation bar, we have bookmarks and notes, and I'll show that a little bit later in the demonstration. And then also a login or logout button. And as you can see, I'm already logged in because it's telling me if I click it, I will log out. So back at the top, I do have the search area. We have two types of search. We have a quick keyword search where a user can just type in a word or two of what they're looking for, or they could do a filtered search and go directly to the type of resource. So we have the instructional resources, the interim connections playlist, professional learning resources, formative assessment strategies, and accessibility strategies. We have grade 3 through 8 in high school resources, English, language arts, and math. And depending on your selections, it's a hierarchy. So then you can also search by claim, target, and standards. We have two resources available on this homepage for users that are free for all users to view and to see what the content is like in an instructional resource. We have an English language arts resource and a mathematics resource. And then at the bottom of the homepage, we have two videos. These are also professional learning resources, but these are just the video links. So if you wanted to know more, you could just go straight to the video, or you could go to the professional learning resource. So two videos, one to understand the Smarter Balance interim assessments and one for understanding the formative assessment process. And then at the bottom of the page, we have another example of the member tenancy. As you can see, we have the South Dakota Department of Education logo. And then there's also an opportunity for member customization here in the left-hand column, where educators can go directly to South Dakota resources. So I'm going to scroll back up, and we're going to start a search. So as I mentioned, we have a keyword search, and I'm going to type in fractions. And when I type in fractions, it is going to run a search and tell me that it's found 13 resources. So the keyword search has this fuzzy type of feature. And what that means is that I could actually spell the word wrong. So say I spelled it out as fractions, because I was in a hurry and I missed the R when I was typing. And if I actually typed that in, it would tell me that it found a few more resources. So this allows the user to, if they make a quick error, they will still get some results back. Another thing that I could do is I can do the keyword search with the filtered search. So let's say, for example, I'm a third grade teacher and I only want to look at third grade resources for fractions. So I click third grade and it now has told me that I have 6 resources. I could either scroll down manually or I can just do a quick jump using this link here to scroll down. The search results will provide this content for the results. It will provide an image card, but then it will give me the type of resource, the resource title, the grade, the content, a brief overview, as well as the claim and target if it's, and standard if it's applicable for that resource. So for example, a professional learning resource will not have a claim and a target. So I want to go to the mile race representing fractions on a number line. And as you can see, there's three columns here. I'm going to start with the column on the right, because this is the column that has the information or the metadata about the resource. So it has the content, the grade level, the claim, target, and standard. You'll notice here it goes dot, dot, dot. I just hover over it, it'll give me the full name of that target. Additionally, it'll tell me if this resource is on a playlist. So if it is on an Interim Connections playlist, that playlist will be listed here. And we'll use that link in just a moment to move over to that site. But the resource also has an outline. So the outline has two functions. One, it gives the user a quick overview of what is in the resource, how the resource is laid out. And it also acts as a quick jump. So I could jump to a specific section. So if I clicked on attachments here, it'll jump me directly down to that attachment link. Also, it works the same way going back up. If I wanna go back to the top and just click get started. In addition to the outline margin, there are some site functionalities that are across the top center. This is the notes feature. This is a new feature in this site. It allows you to take notes on the resource as you go. So as you can see, I put a note in for you guys. Welcome to our demo. If I wanted to add another note, I just simply new note, and I can save. The purpose of the note feature is if there's something I want to remember when I'm using this resource with my students, or it's also a great tool if I've used this resource and I want to give myself a note for when I use it again. So if I might not be teaching this till second semester, or I might be teaching this next year, it allows me to give myself a couple of notes. Additionally, I can share the resource with my colleagues, and I can also bookmark a resource. So just clicking on or off, if it's open, there is no bookmark. Once I've clicked it on, it fills in with blue, and the blue feature will then save it to my bookmarks. We also have print, and then there is this feature called toggle reading mode. And what it does is it expands the section. It lets me focus completely on the content. In this mode, users can still access the content in the left margin and the right margin simply by moving the mouse over to the side, and it will show that content. So if I'm reading the resource and I wanted to just quickly jump to another section, I can just scroll over and the outline will come out and I can jump to that next section. I've already showed you how to jump to the attachments. This was a piece of educator feedback. The educators really like to view the attachments early. So we have a quick button here so they can view the materials that are connected to the instructional resource. Or as I mentioned, they can do a quick jump from the outline. Each resource has the same layout and features, so they all start with a get started section. They all are followed by the step-by-step attachments, accessibility strategies that are used and embedded throughout the resource, things that a teacher might consider when using this resource, the formative assessment process, how it is used in the resource, and then also the strategies. So each resource has an outline. The instructional resource is a little bit different than the formative, but each one has that same functionality, the same outline. So if I move over to get started, I have the overview, the learning goal, and success criteria. Educators have said this information is the most helpful when getting started with a resource, so we wanted it right up front at top. The little purple blue eye, or the purple eye, is an info icon, a tooltip. And if you click on the tooltip, it will tell you what that information is. So an overview is a brief summary of the instructional task. Learning goal, what learning students are to develop. What do we expect them to know, apply, or understand? And then the success criteria for the lesson. Moving on, we have a step-by-step. This is like an instructional recipe for educators as they deliver the content of this lesson. Throughout the step-by-step, you will see that we have some embedded strategies. So if I just scroll over the clover, it'll tell me that that icon represents a formative assessment strategy. When I go to click on that strategy entrance ticket, it will give me a brief description of the strategy. And if I wanted to go directly to that strategy, I could click there and go right from here. And it would take me right to that strategy. Every time the strategy is used, it's hyperlinkable in the site. And we have formative strategies and accessibility strategies throughout. The accessibility strategy is a student or a silhouette. And then again, the same functionality, a brief description of the strategy, and you can go directly there if you want more information. So I'm going to jump down to the accessibility strategies. You can see that if I wanted to go there first, I could by using the outline, and it'll show me the three strategies that are used in this resource. We have things to consider. In this one, we have the mathematical practice standards. And then we also have the formative assessment process and how it's used. So each of the instructional resources in Tools for Teachers uses the formative assessment process. It's really grounded in the formative assessment process. And so this section can be used to help teachers have a stronger understanding of the formative assessment process, how it's used in this resource. This section can also be used for professional learning. And then finally at the bottom, we have a list of the strategies used. Since I was in the notes mode, I need to go back to the regular mode. So this is an instructional resource. Now we're going to jump to the connections playlist that this resource is on. As you can see, we have numbers and operations here. And there are going to be three resources on this playlist. Again, we have the right column with the information about the resource, the content. And instead of having the playlist that's on, there's a quick jump to each of the three resources. In the left column, we have the outline. So it starts with the performance progressions. Then we have suggestions for interventions, things to consider. Background on this specific interim assessment block. And then for those who are new to connections playlists or interim assessment blocks, each interim connections playlist has this informational section at the bottom with the video and some guiding documents on what are interim assessments. For the connections playlist, I like to use the toggle mode for readability as it gives me a little bit more room and expansion here. We have the student performance progressions, which provides observable progressions, where students are when they're below, when they're near and approaching, they're at or above. And then a feature is here, I could minimize the columns. So if I just really want to focus on students at or near the standard, this would be the observable that I'm focusing on when they're comparing and ordering fractions. For students who are significantly below performing at grade level, there are some suggested ideas for skills And then there's also things to consider as they're related to the content standard and target. So in this one, particularly for third grade, the denominators are going to be limited to 2, 3, 4, 6, and 8. And so as a third grade teacher, that's great information as I'm preparing my lessons for my students. The interim assessment background will provide a description of this claim and target, the claim and target that's on this interim, and why it is important for students to learn. Additionally, we have academic vocabulary, which is a list of vocabulary that should be used throughout instruction. It's a combination of different types of vocabulary that can be used in the classroom, including the construct relevant vocabulary that's used to build the assessment. To take a deeper dive into this content target and claim, users could go to the sample items or to the Content Explorer. Again, one of our application goals was this seamless connection between different Smarter Balanced applications. And so this is one example of that. And as I mentioned, for those who are new to the interim assessments, we have that video. We have access to the interim assessment flyer. So jumping back up to the top, I want to show you how the bookmarks work. So as you remember, I bookmarked the last resource we were on. And so I just have to go here to the navigation bar and I can click on bookmarks. And I have that resource right here. For each of these items in my bookmarks, you will see there are four little icons here. So if I have a bookmark, I can easily share it with my colleague. I can know right away if it has notes or if it doesn't have notes. And if I want to go directly to print the resource, I can just click print and it'll take me directly to the resource already into the print status. So one of our goals is to have quick and easy navigation for educators to be able to share resources with each other. So for example, if thumbs up and thumbs down or stars and stares were one of my favorite formative strategies, and I was just telling a colleague how I just used it, I can quickly go back to my computer and share it with them right after lunch. Again, in the navigation bar, we have the formative strategies and the accessibility strategies. So I have, if I click on one of those links or icons, it'll take me to a pre-populated search page with those resources. And if I wanted to go specifically to a strategy that involves maybe writing, it will filter of those formative strategies which one includes writing. And so I am immediately drawn to the role, audience, format, and topic strategy. And so that allows me some quick, easy navigation. As I mentioned earlier, we do have a public and a member view. So this member view is for South Dakota. If I log out, it will take me back to the homepage and you'll notice that my top of my icon, it has changed. The welcome is now Tools for Teachers Smarter Balanced. If I go down to the footer, you will no longer see a member state or territory represented. And it will no longer have that fourth column with those member specific links. So this is the public view. If I go to, for example, a formative strategy in the public view, I will have partial access to the content. I will still be able to see the left margin with the outline. I will still be able to see the right margin, and I will still be able to see the overview. But for full access to the content, I will be prompted to log in. So thank you for joining us today. That is a quick demo of our site. Thank you, everybody.